Honor Lovelies, welcome back. This is going to be my flip through explanation of my beautiful BBW, because you know my mini was slim thick. My classic is my BBW, and I was actually trying to wait on doing this video because, you know, us being planner babes as we are, we want our planners to be all pretty and perfect before, you know, we share with everybody. But I've had a lot of requests to do a flip through of my setup since I've already done a flip through of my mini for 2021. So I will go ahead and link that below so you can check that one out if you like. But today we're gonna get into my very chunky classic, and yes, that is the correct number of dividers dashboards you see up there, and you will understand as I go through this why it is so chunky and why it has so many planners functioning planned into it. So even with the pandemic, or with it being over, whatever the case may be, my job is still virtual, so I work from home. So I don't like having my planners all scattered around, or even if they're in the same place, I don't like having to pull a different planner over and over just so I can use it. I like having everything in one place. This sits on my desk, and y'all, I just realized what I forgot. If you're new to my channel, please be sure to like, subscribe, share, tell a friend, hit the notification bell. Those returning, I appreciate the love and support. How can I forget that, y'all? I'm like slipping on my pimper right now. So anyway, yes, with me being at home, I like my planner, just everything in one place. I rotate it out, you know, the months when I need to. But other than that, she should stay everything together on my desk. Now, I do have one other classic that I'm using, which is used for my journaling. But that I keep on my nightstand by my bed because it reminds me to journal every night, because yeah, I don't always remember. So that staying next to my bed reminds me to do that, and I go ahead and journal every night. This may, you know, I may bring it to the room with me sometimes if I need to work on something in there, or, you know, arrange some things in there, then okay. But other than that, it will stay on my desk. So without further ado, let's get into it. So first thing you will notice, I am using the gold expander disc. I have no choice but to use the gold expander disc because that's just how it goes. You will understand when you see it. But I'm also using this is not a deluxe cover. It's the black leather hardcover. It comes in a classic, also comes in a mini. You will see the mini on my mini on the go planner. It is not sure if it's still available on the Happy Planner site. If it is, I will link it below, but I'm pretty sure you can still get it on Amazon. I will add that link as well. Then when you get into it, you see this beauty. I am using, why is it like that? I'm using the Teresa Collins Classic Vertical Planner. I usually go for like the pretty color theme, such and such, whatever planner. But as much as I love them, I have noticed that I do get a little frustrated sometimes when I have to constantly cover up because I want to do a different style theme or something. So that's why I went with the Teresa Collins. And honestly, I have not used a classic vertical planner in about, I would say maybe a year, something like that. So it will be interesting to get back into this. So as you can see, I've already put my name on there. Ooh, what is that? Because I am serious. This is going to be my planner. I have gotten better about sticking with my planners, which is really good, because when I first started out, I was just flip-flopping between any and every. And if you guys hear my kids in the background, I apologize. There, it's Friday. I don't give them bedtime on Friday, so they're a little turned up right now. But yeah, so I've gotten better at sticking with my planners, and I think that's because, what is that? Ew. We'll deal with that later. But I think that's because I've, if not found planner peace, I'm just about there with planner peace. So I think that's why. And this video might be a bit stretched out. I apologize. It's a very thick planner. So, yeah. And it's not fully completed. It's, I would say, 98% finished with the setup, but that'll work. So then we go into my word for the year. I'm going to walk you through my whole little setup. And my word for the year is consistent, and I'm going to be as consistent as I can with everything, including the use of my planner. So, yeah. And then that's just the things that I want to be consistent with. For this page, I actually use the detailed floral sticker book. Then we go into my, is that double? No. Then we go into my 2021 vision board. I will also link the video below where I created this. I have not, although it is created, I have not actually added my pictures on there. I do have each section, family, self, spiritual, finance, and home. They're all ready. I just need to pop in my little clip art pictures. So then we get to this part here. Now these are the, I believe they're listed as page protectors. I believe that's what they're listed as. I'll link those below as well. Each section in my planner has one of these sheets in whatever shape they may be in. But it lists my goal and my step for my goals. Now this first section of my planner is my everyday planner. So these goals are goals regarding the family and the house. Like, that's it. And of course I use my little doll from, goodness, from Stickers by Rhonda. I will also link her shop below with my PR code. Check it out. She has gorgeous dolls in all shades and hair types, hair colors. They're great. So that's what I use that for. These are just little pockets, and I actually use Happy Planner filler paper and their stickers and cloth boxes. And then the back, I just put some inspirational stuff. Then this is my DIY other fun dates. I've actually had this, I think it's over a year now, and I feel like I need to do a new one. So I probably will. I'm not sure. But something that just kind of goes a bit more with the tones I have. But we'll see. I will see. Then we go into my, oh goodness, my, y'all, it just left my mind. It just left my mind. My perpetual calendar. Is that my original calendar? I believe it is. But anyway, this is pretty much going to be for meal planning. That's all it is. Like, I have the Ultra Micro 0.38 pen, so I can actually write two lines, and that's all that's going to be is meal planning. Because to stick to my budget, meal planning would really help, and I can, you know, look at what I had for 1 month and decide, okay, well, we're gonna rotate this, or we're gonna do this again, or that wasn't so great, so that, so. And I'm trying to go through this a little quicker so it's not extremely long. And then we move into the actual planner itself. Now this section is titled Remember, and that is because I actually got the idea from, is it Happy Brown Desiree? Seriously, Chanel? You just totally just forgot? Yeah, you forgot. But anyway, I will link her video below, her channel below as well. And she uses this section as memory keeping. And I thought that's a great plan because I don't usually use this area, but it would be nice to have like highlights of my month, and it'll kind of be like my memory keeping for the year as well. And you know, maybe reflecting on things that happened, special dates, things like that. So that's why it's titled Remember. These dashboards, dashboards actually come in a 3-pack from Hobby Lobby. And you get that one, this one, and did I already pass it? You get that one, this one, and this dotted one. So yeah, so that's that. Then we go into all my months have the little lashes just because it was easier and I had so many of them. Ignore this. So then we get into the month. And as you can see, it is very neutral, which I am so happy about because it's just going to be way easier to decorate. Like I said, I love the theme planners and the pretty colors and all that, but it did get to a point where it was just too much having to cover up, and you know, I was spending more money on labels and things like that because it was just too much white out, so I would use the Avery labels and stuff like that to cover it, and it was just doing too much. So I love this. It's like a nice blank slate. Perfect. Then we get into the weekly, which again, very neutral and cute tones of blush pink that work out really well. One second, that work out really well, that even if I didn't want to use that color for whatever reason, it's one simple sticker instead of a bunch of different stickers. Like, it's just way easier to cover up. So then we get into, oh, and this only has my full section, I believe, till April. And then May. Yes, I put the month and the weeks up until April. And then after that, it is just the month without the week. All my weeks are sectioned off and designated with tabs that keep them separated as they need to be. And they're stored in another planner cover set. It didn't have anything in there, so I just put some rings on it, put the planner cover, and they're taken care of. And that way I can have my months, because even if I don't need the full weeks, I still like having my months where I can look ahead, because sometimes I may be in February, but I need to look at June for whatever reason. And since I'm using the little perpetual calendar for meal planning, it's not like I can look and see, oh, well, you have this plan. No. So this is how I'm doing it. And that was the only way I can actually fit them all, is if I go ahead and just pull the weeks out. So then we get into my work/business planner, which is really just business because my work is pretty much repetitive. Same thing. I don't really need to plan for it unless there's like a meeting, which I can put that on my regular planner. This is more for the business that I am. It's actually two. One I'm restarting, and then one that I'm starting up from scratch. What is with that? So this cover or title page is actually from a planner that my sister-in-law gave me. It's only a 12-month planner, but it starts in July, I believe. July of 2020 and ends June of 2021. So I will probably have to replace that, but we'll see. So then when you get in here, this is for me to set any, you know, maybe business things I need to look at. Then this is my another one of those page protectors. This one is just a large two pocket. And these are my business goals, which you can see I'm still filling in the steps for those. But these are the main business goals that I have. And again, my little doll, she looks like she's going to work. So, yeah. Again, motivational quote. This is my DIY goal setting sheet. I found that if I follow these steps, I tend to accomplish 95% of my goals. Because sometimes I don't. And that's only because, you know, I may slack a little bit, but I tend to get them done as long as I follow these steps. Again, I just took regular Happy Planner filler paper, decorated, colorful boxes, letter, alphabet sticker book, and threw that together. Then we get to the, I believe it's called Girls with Goals extension pack. Now, this is only in here for the first month because this first month is going to be a lot more, can't show you that, it's going to be a lot more about, I would need to schedule a lot more at this point because I really need to schedule times and everything as far as working on certain things. It's going to take a lot of figuring out and basically arranging times to where I'm not so caught up in this that I'm not spending time with the family, because I mean basically it's going to be a second job in a way, but I don't want it to be so much so that it takes away from time with my kids in the evening or with hubby, things like that. Like, no. So it's very neutral, it's undated. I actually went ahead and dated for the month of January so that it was set to go. These are some things I need to fill in, and that's how I pre-plan my months. I used to put sticky notes, but for some reason I don't know if maybe I pre-plan too far ahead, and sometimes the sticky notes would be hard to get off or they tear and it started to bother me, so I just use the little filler sheets and write things in and put in there. So as you can see, there is a flip through that I did of this goal setting extension pack, and I will link that below. That is my weekly. And then we get to the next section, which is my budget section. And again, another sheet with goals where you can see I'm still working on and all that. Then we get into my DIY bill sheet. I still have to fill those in. Now, how I do my bill pay sheet, it has the date on it. Like some that are set, like my rent and phone, those I just pop in. My electric, gas, things like that, I actually take all my bills for the 12 months. So I'll take all of my electric bills and then I will do an average, and that is what I would list as my monthly payment, and I would budget for that amount. Then if for whatever reason it's a little cheaper, okay, if it's a little higher, which it really shouldn't be, but then I, you know, will be adjust accordingly, but I always budget a little over what it should be. These are my subscriptions. I just didn't put those in yet. And then on the back, this is actually two sheets from, what was that girl? From the Socialite line. And the back was actually different, so I just take two together. So now on the back, I have my bi-weekly items I need to pay on, my paydays, other things. I also need to add right here my yearly items, like domain payments and things like that. We'll go right there. Then here, because I'm using Experian to boost my credit score, as I pay things off, I want to keep track every month just to see how steadily it rises, or if I did something wrong and it might drop 1 month. Whatever the case may be, that's there. Then we have my Saveopoly. It actually comes blank. You fill in all the things you want. You give yourself the rules that you want. And it is basically every week for a year. And whatever, you know, you have dice, your piece, all that. Whatever I roll on this will actually go into my emergency fund. And that's how I will determine what goes into my emergency fund. Just because it will be a lot easier. Now, here is actually the month from that hourly planner that I told you. You probably hear my daughter flushing the toilet. Oh, real life mom moment. I don't know why she does that. Like, she will open the bathroom door and then flush the toilet. I don't know. It's just so loud. But anyway, so I took the month from that. And I don't use the weeklies. I will plug them in here and there if I want to change into an hourly. But I took the month, and I'm basically using the month as my budgeting section where I can break everything down. These are from Caffeinated Kate. Yes, Caffeinated Kate. They are downloadable, printable budget kits, which works out great if you're... say you're on a tight budget, but you like to have budget kits and you don't want to basically spend that money every single month on a new kit. You can just find one that you really like, download it, and, you know, print them off. If you have a Cricut or a Silhouette machine, I have a Cricut, it was perfect. If you don't, just get a simple little trimmer and just trim the boxes with it. You know, maybe use some scissors, cut those out. You just make it work for you. So then I'm taking regular Happy Planner filler sheets and using the printable budget stickers from Caffeinated Cake and sticking those on there. That's actually what I tried it out in December, and it worked out great. I figured out what I needed, where I needed it, and it went really well. Now right here, I did not realize that my colored ink was running out, so that ended up a little wonky, but I don't want to waste any sticker paper or ink, so I just left it. And obviously I forgot to draw the lines in like I did everywhere else, so I have to go back and draw those lines in. And that will be my budget. But her kit, this is the add-on. She has a basic kit that's one sheet, and it's your expenses, variable expenses, just a bunch of different things. I will link her Etsy shop below. And there's like so many different designs and styles, and you can get the the months of the year, things like that. It's my weekly check-in, sinking funds, transaction log. Now, when I have transaction log, the reason this section is so small is because I use my spending tracker. I just track it in my cash envelope ledgers, or I track it using my mobile app for Navy Federal. But here, I like to track what's going in my savings, because although I have cash envelopes and sinking funds, certain bills that I pay online, I take the portion that I would say, oh, well, this is going to be stashed this week to go towards that bill. I move it to my savings. Anyone that has to be paid online or can be paid online, especially with the way things are now. I just, like, if I know my internet is a set amount and I divide that up into four, and I just move that bit of money to my savings every time I get paid. And then when the bill is come due, I transfer the entire amount, pay the bill. So that makes it easier. So my transaction log is anything that I spend out of sinking funds, which is why it's so small, because I shouldn't be touching my sinking funds unless it's an absolute emergency. So there's that. And then I have 2 months of that. Each of these sections has 2 months of the setup, because I just like to be able to see ahead at least into that second month, except for my everyday planner, of course, because I need all of those months ahead. Then we get into my health and wellness section, which I am using undated planners. I have an undated fitness planner that this came from, which was given to me by my sister-in-law as well. And then I also have the undated Happy Planner extension pack. So this, which there's a video for that too. So again, my goals for my health, some motivational stickers. I will be putting in the pictures and things like that, like starting off and stuff like that, my progress. Then I have my weight tracker. Now, I take my weight every day, then take an average at the end of the week, because according to a trainer and hubby, that is your true weight, because your weight fluctuates through the day, every day. So I take in my weekly setup, I take my weight every day, then get an average. Then at the end of the month, I average those four end amounts, and then that'll give me my weight for the month. I mean, right now it's not necessarily losing weight. I'm more so just trying to maintain and tone what I have, which I have been doing really well. My weight fluctuates, but it stays within a 3 to 5 pound average, so. And I know exactly why, because your girl does have her binge days, but it's okay, because we all need a cheat day. And telling you, that salted caramel mocha frap from Starbucks, it's a weakness, y'all. It's a weakness. Then I have my measurement sheet, which I actually have to make my other one for after the 6 months. So yeah, I actually got that idea from At Home with Keita, like I think about a year. I don't know, but I really liked it, so we are doing it again. And I'm starting the year off with the extension pack, and then I will use, you know, basically rotate. Now the reason I like the original extension pack is because it's pretty neutral, and the layout allows me to track everything. Breakfast, snack, lunch, dinner. I can either use it to track or I can pre-plan. It's completely up to me. Exercise is calorie total. I usually put a box over that and I track my steps. And of course I'd be tracking my weight, so I'll probably track it there, whatever way I want to set it up. But I am currently using the undated newer layout, which is very cute. It has a lot of color, so if I do want to change up the layout or I just want color, I can rotate with that. So it's 2 months of that. Then we go social media. My social media planner is the... What is the social media planner? Y'all don't even understand. It's the 18-month floral, and it's a monthly planner. And then, pretty much, this is going to be my social media hub, because after my mini wild styles is completed, I will be moving everything social media into this, just because it's easier, so my mini will just be completely one planner and a note section, because I do need note paper. I do jot things down when I'm on the go. So you go in here, my monthly area. Now, well, this is one that I didn't get to yet. You can see I have the goals written down. I just haven't made the sheet. That's what I said. She's about 90 something percent done. I haven't even worked on that little tidbit there, so we're gonna just bypass that. But my month section is basically gonna be where I track what I'm going to plan, and I will, well, what I'm going to record. And I have one. Where are you? I believe. Did I do it in this? Hold on, y'all. I'm about to check something really quick. Because I don't think I did it for November because I've been so busy. No, I didn't. That's not good. So I can't show y'all because I didn't do it. Okay. So pretty much how I use this, I left it, the other one way over there. I'm not going for it. But how I use it is I list what I'm filming, what day, what I'm uploading, what day. So Mondays will be Mini Monday all the way down, right? But I put Mini Monday. I put what video I'm uploading for whatever date to whatever date. And then I put what video I'm filming from whatever date to whatever date. But I, underneath the video that I'm filming, I write down what either the theme is or what sticker book I'm going to use. And I do that for the entire month before the month starts. And by me doing that, it keeps me from repeating certain spreads, because I have lately been really big on florals, and I've noticed I'll catch myself up to like a whole 2 weeks of floral spreads, and it's like, okay, you need something different. So this helps me from repeating certain spreads too often. And then this is a printable for my home Aquita, the home Aquita, and this is actually going to be for any video, you know, content ideas that are not planned with me. So my month is all planned with me. This is anything that's not a plan with me, maybe a DIY, or I've never done Vlogmas, so I don't know, but I've been told that I should try it, so we'll see how I feel about all that. Then you get into this section where, how'd I skip that? This section where I will actually break down certain things like tracking that I'm uploading on time, my goals for the month as far as social media, tracking, you know, whatever the case may be. Oh, I also didn't show you guys that this I actually use to write my stats once in a while as far as YouTube subscribers and IG followers, which as you can see, I have not updated that either. I don't do it every day. Every once in a while I go back, sometimes every 4 days, just to see how, you know, the flow is going based on what I'm posting or uploading. And then this will be where I will break it down into the PR teams I'm on, then purely Instagram, purely Facebook, and what I'm posting, you know, what day, whatever the case may be. So that's going to be for PR teams, especially once my mini wild style is finished. It will be solely in this, no more mini. Then of course 2 months of that, and then this is my I did it section, which is pretty much DIYs or notes. That's why it's I did it. So it's anything that I create that I haven't really put a section for, or ideas that I may have. Ooh, and I have that goal sheet still. I forgot that was back there. But yeah, so that's what that section is. And then, of course, the Teresa Collins. So yeah, that is my BBW classic baby. She is just thick and she does not care. That is my 2021 setup, y'all. So again, I will link all those other videos down below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, share, tell a friend, hit that notification bell, check out the shops that I mentioned. You will not be disappointed. And yeah, have a great one, lovelies. Oh, you can also find me over on Instagram under the same name, Cooler Planner Babe. And you can either comment below, DM me, or if you want to, you can email me at coolliphunterbabe@gmail.com. So yeah, have a great one, lovelies.